Hey everybody, it's Boardman21 and today's video is going to be on the Shaman and we're going to be updating our Freeze Shaman build. However, we're not going to be going 100% into Freeze. Instead, we wanted to use Freeze as a CC that can help us, but more than that, we wanted to have really good defense. So in this build, we'll be going for some of the new set of fixes that you can get, which actually pop up quite often when you're gambling. And it's quite difficult to get the set that we have. I mean, it's going to take a little bit, but the set that I've made I can use on just about any character that wants to run dodge and protection. So I'll be using this exact same set on almost every character because it's a universal set that you don't have to worry about making different ones for other characters. So unless you're playing on solo, self-found, on hardcore or softcore, it's not going to be a huge deal for you once you get it. However, getting it the first time will take some time. It took us about 10 million gold overall, and we've been looking for the pieces for a while now. We finally finished it up, and I can now do some builds with it. So let's go ahead and get into this one. For skills, we're going to be running Ice Thorns, Summon Thorn Totem, Maelstrom, Avalanche, and Tempest Strike. For Ice Thorns, we have this set up with 1 point Emblem of Might to have a 0 mana cost while using a two-handed weapon. We are not using a two-handed weapon in this video. We are switching back and forth, so feel free to take this 1 point out and put somewhere else. For me, I would put it in Bark Shield. We have 1 point in Nymophili, 1 point in Thorn Shield, 4 points in Bulb Shield, 1 point in Second Nature, 6 points in Fluoric Tides, 3 points in Bark Shield, and 3 points in Eternal Protection. For Summon Thorn Totem, we have 3 points in Forested Expanse, 3 points in Eternal Forest, 1 point in Groove Mind, 2 points in Memories of Edera, 5 points in Venom Tipped Thorns, 1 point in Lasting Affliction, 3 points in Rotten Core, 1 point in Ice Thorn Totems, and 1 point in Frost Attunement. For Maelstrom, we're using this for both dodge and for healing, and for chill chance and freeze. So a little bit of everything on this one. We have 3 points in Turmoil, 2 points in Arctic Chill, 3 points in Healing Winds, 3 points in Arctic Blast, 1 point in Sudden Gale, 2 points in Calm, 3 points in Sleet Footed, and 3 points in Whirlpool. For Avalanche, this is our Cast and Forget. We're also using it for some chill. We have 1 point in Mountain Peak, 1 point in Precision, 1 point in Wild Path, 4 points in Unyielding Storm, 1 point in Hailstorm, 2 points in Naturally Occurring, 4 points in Dead of Winter, 1 point in Frost, 2 points in Frost Touch, and 3 points in Shatter Shot. And then for Tempest Strike, we have 1 point in Static, 5 points in Unspent Power, 1 point in Reinforced Stone, 1 point in Thirsty Blades, 1 point in Charged Stone, 1 point in Dead Wind, 1 point in Lightning Can Strike Twice, 1 point in Storm Strike, 2 points in With the Wind, 4 points in Storm's Aid, 1 point in Tempestuous, and 1 point in Mute the Earth. For passives, we have 20 points in the base Primals class, with 4 points in Gift of the Wilderness, 6 points in Natural Attunement, 5 points in Wisdom of the Wild, and 5 points in Tempest Born. 0 points in Beastmaster, 10 points in Druid, all 10 points in Barkskin, and 83 points in our Mastered Shaman, with 8 points in Shamanic Infusion, 8 points in Silent Protector, 8 points in Tempest Form, 10 points in Windbringer, 5 points in Hailbringer, 5 points in Shattered Heavens, 10 points in Harrowed's Path, 5 points in Protective Circle, 8 points in Ruin of Awe, 8 points in Elemental Shrines, and 8 points in Ascendant Circle. For items, we have 2 types of idols. We have healing effectiveness and poison protection idols, and we have chance to summon a thorn totem on hit along with increased cold damage per active totem. Both of these will help you. The healing makes the healing of Maelstrom heal you for more, and the cold damage increase obviously is going to make all of your cold skills do more damage. On top of that, for the weapon, we are running a Divine Scepter with spell damage, cold damage, freeze rate multiplier, and elemental protections. For the chest, we have Glancing Blow on it. We have freeze rate per stack of chill, increased dodge. We have some vitality. We have the same stuff, except instead of the chance for Glancing Blow, we put cold damage on our helm. And for our belt, we have set Glancing Blow, increased armor, chance to receive Glancing Blow when hit, and more armor. And then for our shield, set Glancing Blow again, block chance, more glancing blow, and then armor and protection flat. Now, the rest of these pieces are going to be tough, okay? So what we did is, for the rest of them, you can have the set pieces. We wanted set dodge, we wanted set elemental, we wanted set void and armor, and set void necrotic and poison. That's four different sets, and there's not a lot of room. So what we did is we did a perfect three set of all four of them on the remaining items. Now, you can mix these up a little bit, not too much, but for the most part, what you want is you want to get three set dodges, three necrotic and poisons, three void and armors, and three elemental protection sets each, all in the prefix slots. So on our rings, we have set dodge and set elemental. On the other one, we have set necrotic and poison with set dodge. We have set elemental protection and set armor and void on the relic. We have set elemental and set armor and void on the necklace, on the amulet. And then for the boots, we have set armor protection, set necrotic and poison. And then for the gloves, we have set dodge and set necrotic and poison. And between all of those, we have three of each. And what that does is really even out your protection, so you're not too worried about that. And then for the suffixes, you can do whatever you want. We threw in a lot of extra dodge, but you can also get quite a bit of protections. We do have movement speed on the boots, but feel free to do protections or do some other sort of, you could do health if you really wanted. And what that leads us to is we have almost 1500 to 2000 of all protections, and these of course go up when we have a totem active. So if I have one totem active, they instantly jump up. We double our elementals, we have good armor, and we still have decent necrotic, void, and poison. On top of that, you get 25 protections for each totem that you have. So when you summon the five thorn totems, these get up by quite a bit more, but you'll have at least 60% damage reduction of all. Now, we do have our 104% glancing blow. We only ran set glancing blow on three pieces, and that was the helm, the shield, and the belt. We couldn't put it on anything else, and that's why we have it in the suffix slot on the chest, the belt, and the helm. And if you need to, you can put another suffix on the shield if you didn't quite make that 100%. We have 34% dodge, but as you know, as we get Maelstrom going, that's actually going to increase. We get all the way up to 60% dodge. So we actually have really good defense, and on top of that, we leech some life, and we do a lot of healing. All right, I'm going to go ahead and give you guys some gameplay. This build did do really well against the bosses. They weren't able to one-shot us at all, even if we stood in the damage zones. The damage of the build output, it does a lot of little hits, so the damage mitigation really comes into effect against bosses, but it does decent damage. We did manage to freeze the bosses a couple of times during the gameplay, and you'll see that.